Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. And if you are new here, hi, my name is Valentina. In today's video, I'm going to test a new foundation and I'm going to do this eye makeup look. It is very simple and I've used like one product. So if you like what you see and want to find out more, then keep on watching. So the foundation I'm going to test for today's video is this Even Better Clinical by Clinique. This is Even Better Clinical Serum Foundation with SPF 20. I've never tried a foundation by Clinique, so I'm very curious to see how this foundation performs on my acne textured skin. It has vitamin C, salicylic acid, and hyaluronic acid. It's for a free, sweat and humidity resistant, waterproof, non-acnegenic. Has all the claims that I look for, so I'm very excited to try it. I've got the shade 01 Flex WN. This is how it looks like. You have to twist and pull the cap. And this has a pump, which is very nice. I believe this WN01, it's the lightest shade. So we will see if this shade will be a good match. I'm not sure how are you supposed to apply this. I usually like to apply my foundation with a beauty blender. But for you guys, I could apply it on one side of the face with my beauty blender and on the other side by using a brush. I'm very curious about the results of this foundation because my skin is not looking good these days. I was very stressed and that's why I have all of these blemishes. And I'm curious to see how this foundation will cover them. Usually I like a sheer coverage and natural finish. So this side of the face will be the side with the brush, and on this side I am going to apply this with a beauty blender. This is like a pump. Here I have the foundation. This is how it looks like. I'm going to apply it with this Real Techniques brush. You'll definitely have a more full coverage finish if you are using a brush. I don't like how it looks on me. I feel like it looks more cakey on the side with a brush. And I like that on this side the skin is even and I have a pretty finish. So I'm going to go on this side with a beauty blender and try to shear it. I think the shade is a pretty good match. You could definitely have a full coverage finish if you are using a brush. But for me, I like the side with the beauty blender. I think it looks more natural. And I have just the right amount of coverage on this side. I feel like here, my dry patches are more visible. So far, it's looking pretty. We will see by the end of the video. We will move on to concealer. This is Born This Way concealer by Too Faced. I like this very, very much and I like to apply a tiny amount of this. And I'm going to set my concealer and I'm going to apply some powder because I usually apply powder all over my face. I'm going to apply this battery hyaluronic hydro powder. For my bronzer, I'm going to use this Bare Mineral in the shade Warmth. I really like this bronzer. It gives my skin a nice bronzy look without being very obvious. Didn't experience any problems in applying my bronzer over this foundation. And for my blush, I'm going to apply this Couture blush by Yves Saint Laurent in the shade 9. This is the shade. I've applied a little bit too much, but that's okay because I'm going to go over with my beauty blender with whatever's left from my foundation and blend this into the skin. And for my highlighter, I'm going to use the one that I use all the time and I know that it's good. And it's this Dior Backstage Face and Glow Palette. I really like this highlighter. It has a subtle finish and is holding onto the skin like all day. So far all the products were applied very nicely. So I'm going to move on to the eyes. So I'm not going to prime my eyelids because I want to do a very simple smoky eye look. And I'm going to use this Urban Decay Glide-On Eye Pencil. This is waterproof and long-lasting, and I've noticed if I prime my eyelids and I set them with powder, I cannot blend this well, so I have to use it on my bare eyelids. And because it's waterproof, I will not have any problems later in smudges and something like this. So, what I like to do, I'm going to take this and put this closer to my lash line. And then I will go over with this brush by Glove. It's like a flat brush and kind of stiff. Something like this. And you have to go over and blend it very quickly because this will dry out very fast. Do this on the other side. I'm going to put some on my lower lash line, but only here on the outer part. I'm not going to drag it further. And connect it with this side. And drag this towards the end of my eyebrow, like this. I'm going to put some in here. And blend this like to be my crease. I'm going to put some on the waterline, like in here. And on the bottom waterline, I'm going to use this white kohl pencil by Max Factor. This is white and will help open the eyes a little bit. Going in with the same highlighter, and I'm going to take this shade and put it on my inner corner. I'm going to quickly apply mascara and then we'll be right back. So this is the finished makeup result. For my mascara, I've used one of my favorite mascaras of all times, which is this Dareal by Benefit. This is the first Dareal mascara. I have to say that I don't like the magnet one, but I've mentioned this in my previous videos. And on my lips, I've used this L'Oreal Lip Liner Couture in the shade Beige Anime. As my lipstick, I've used this Velvet Teddy by MAC. I really like this combo, it's very pretty. So final impressions of this Clinique, Even Better Clinical Serum Foundation, has a pretty finish. I have to say that on the side, when I've applied it with a brush, it looks a little bit cakey on this side, and on the Beauty Blender side, it looks way better and more natural. It claims that with time, your skin will look better and will improve. So I'm very curious to see this happening. I will definitely keep you updated about this foundation. I'm going to wear it until my next video and have a final impression. But I really want to know if this will break me out, because this is a huge deal for me. So that's it for today's video. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and also ring the bell to be notified when I upload. I post every week, so make sure to hit that notification bell. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.